Good morning, everyone. It is Brian Early here. All of the Starfish Clan are in bed except for myself, so what better opportunity will I have to record some more Lightseekers action for you? This morning, I'm just going to be working on a couple of missions. Looks like I've got a storm mission here. I haven't done any storm videos yet, so let's have a quick look at what storm deck I have at the moment. So I have Fishing at Ushi deck here, and this is not a great deck. I just kind of threw this together so that I could complete some storm missions. So we've just got some fairly standard stuff in this deck, nothing too exciting. So let us queue up for a game. Hopefully somebody is awake at this time. As always, we're just going to be playing casual in the hopes that we can actually win. Raining outside today, as is often the case in Manchester. Come on. There we go, someone's up. Either that or somebody from America is up late. Storm versus storm. Okay, so Electro Hopper, always nice to see at the start. We can just get this out early and start chipping away at our opponent. Of course, right now he has no buffs in place, so it might be a good idea to play Living Cloud. Bubblefish is going to slow that down a little bit, so we're not going to bother with Living Cloud or Electro Hopper right now, as they would be negatively affected by Bubblefish. Instead, we're just going to throw in Hurricane Spirit, see if we can get ourselves a few extra cards, and then I suppose we could heal. Particularly we want to play right now, so we'll just end our turn. Hooray! Double heroic Starfish. So we're going to be playing some explosions cards now. This is definitely one thing about the app which is not too good at the moment, is that when our opponents play a weapon, we have to wait until our own turn before we can click on that weapon and see what it is and what it does. Would be useful to be able to do that as soon as it had been played. Obviously our Hurricane Spirit just got removed, which is a bit of a shame. And we can't play any buffs now because they'll just get removed. So yeah, definitely nothing here worth playing, so we're just going to draw for now. For anyone who hasn't seen it before, Fishing Oroshi's ability is, if I can click on him, I can't see my own hero's ability either, but he makes my combos one cheaper. Okay, so yeah, we can throw an Electro Hopper now, because we've got no other buffs in play, none that I really want to play either, and we might as well just deliver a crab for a bit of healing. I have a feeling that when I put this deck together, I was working on a mission where I had to play two cost combos as well, so I think probably most of the combos in this deck only cost two to play, which in the case of Fishing Oroshi will mean that they only cost one to play. So we can get that Living Cloud out finally. And then there's nothing there that we want to play, so let's draw. There we go, three heroic starfishes. So 9 healing, I mean, we'd really rather that doesn't go off, especially if it's going to go off. so you can see I've got plenty of removal here. Let's just throw a starfish then, because maybe we can free will in there. And then we'll just draw. Not really going to be able to do anything with Storm Shaman right now. We haven't really got that many attack cards. Okay, we've still got another turn before we need to remove this guard snail, so we'll see if any more buffs come out next turn. We might want removing. If we play it now, of course, he's not going to play any buffs, so we don't want that to happen. We can avoid it. Whenever I see a heroic starfish, in particular when someone plays one against me, I'm always reminded of the match that I played at Manchester Regionals, where someone with glee played a heroic starfish on me, thinking that they'd reduce me to zero health, only to realise that I had a crystal core in the back. Okay, I'll play birds on the captain, so that's just going to reduce damage. That's okay. Well, we really need to get rid of that guard snail because we really don't want him to heal for 9. Okay, we'll just get rid of that. And we can delivery crab as well. So the first of our combos. We can play another starfish since we can heal for 3. Not really anything else we want to play. Certainly don't want to put another Electro Hopper in since they'll cancel each other out. So yeah, we'll just draw for now. Problem with using that weapon at the moment is that it's really not doing enough damage per turn to make it worthwhile. Guards now. Don't think we're going to be able to take off 20 damage before he gets that round, so potentially we'll have to remove that with our last Thunder Slug. Second Thunder Slug, we've only used one so far. Right, okay, so I guess, yeah, we'll go with Hurricane Spirit, try and get some more card draw going on. And we can use another Heroic Starfish as well. Not really. Choose first to turn by rotation. It's going to rotate, so that doesn't actually sound that amazing. Oh no. I see now. It only rotates if I have no buffs, and that's going to be a tough one, given that I've got a permanent buff in play. So that's unfortunate. I'll have to be removed at some point. Okay. Yep, so we're just going to draw for now, I think. Buff there. Not very useful, given that I haven't played any buffs yet. Okay, well, I mean, I would like to use this, but I can only do one wind action per turn, and it's going to have to be Thunder Slug. Just to stop that 9 healing from going up. That, so let's just draw. Been caught out before with the Thunder Slug. I don't know if you'd call it an issue, but because it says you may remove, you have to actually select them. A lot of removal when you play it, it picks the buffs for you. There's only a couple of them. With Thunder Slug, you have to remember to tick them. Right, so let's get Hurricane Spirit on the go. This is going to fill up our hand a little bit, so we are susceptible to a Cleaver Jester. Hopefully that won't happen. So, lots of attack guards now. Yeah, it's flashing at me. Might as well use Living Cloud, or if it's got no buffs on the face. And why not? We've got an Electro Hopper to pay for it with. So I think probably next turn we'll throw down a Storm Shaman, assuming this is still around. Could always go with me. To go off, then that'll be an 8 damage combo there, and then we'd be able to finish him off with the Spark Wisp. So let's just draw. Ah, that's great. So, yeah, if that Storm Shaman manages to successfully rotate, we can play Spark Wisp and Dancing Flutterer. And I don't think he's going to be able to heal beyond that level. Certainly, that Hurricane Hammer is not going to help him. Okay, so this is going to be game, so we will just, good game here, and there we go. Alright, so we're not quite there with our storm mission, so we'll just play one more. We have got a loot chest, let's open it. Nothing new, unfortunately. Who else are we going to find on mine at this time? That's the question. One of the starter deck heroes. From the app, I should say. Not a starter deck hero in real life. Right, let's just throw out Hurricane Spirit, see if we can get that to go off. And nothing else there I want to play right now. Turns before I need to worry about it though. I don't think he's going to be able to rotate that forward, hopefully. So I'm just going to draw for now. Never know, he might play another buff, which we can get rid of with Thunder Slug. Like that one there. Okay, so once again, we've got Hurricane Spirit primed, and I suppose if I play Hurricane Spirit now, that's going to remove his last two cards, which means that he's definitely not going to be able to rotate this forward, and I can get rid of it next time. So let's do that, just in case it's going to get removed. course, I won't be able to play Thunderstorm now because I've already played a Wind Action. I'm pretty sure it's going to say that. Yeah, there we go. So we can't do that. So let's just Heroic Starfish. Okay, definitely going to get rid of that Prism Cannon Mark too. And what else do we want to do? Let's throw in another Hurricane Spirit. And of course I can. Okay, let's just Spikeless Reviver. Get rid of his Rickety Man before it hits us. It's going to then let us play Living Cloud because he's got no buffs. And then Hurricane Spirit. Well, I'd rather that didn't go off, but there's not much I can do about it, unfortunately. So we'll just draw for now. Now Mrs. Starfish waking up upstairs now. Healing this turn, couldn't I? So let's vitalize him Frog to start. And then Hurricane Spirit. So this is going to be handy now. I can play this and it'll just chip away his Mountain Fort over the next few turns. Never a big fan of wasting attack cards in Mountain Fort. And then we can just heal again. There we go, chipping away. So let's throw in a Delivery Crab just to get extra care. And I don't really want to be using these at the moment, like I say, with the Mountain Fort in play, it just seems like a bit of a waste. So we'll just draw for now. He's got no buffs again, so we'll just Living Cloud. And Heroic Starfish. Could really do with a Wind card at this point to be able to play Flying Debris, but of course I've not got one. The rain's coming down again outside. It's quite a sunny day actually, it must be. Patch of sky with no cloud in it. So obviously I would rather that not go off, but I don't have any removal right now. that to not go off as well. So let's just dig for a little bit of removal, shall we? I've used two thunder slugs already, so oh no, maybe just one. So yeah, there are two more in there. Still, it's like a 1 in 8 chance of drawing one each time I draw a card right now. We'll give it another go though, because I do want one if I can get one. In fact, I can use Delivery Crab to draw one of those cards. Nope. And one last go. No. Okay, so now I'm not going to be able to get one in time to stop this Prism Cannon, which is a bit of a shame. Especially as he's played Colossi Ritual Site. So that is going to hit for 11, and then that will hit for 7 as well. So I'm going to get hit for 18 now before he plays any cards. So I suppose I will heal for all that I can, in the hopes that I can survive this. But this may not go my way. So the only other question is, can I potentially kill him on the following turn, if I manage to survive this next turn? So I can do 5 damage here and 3 here, that would be 8 on the next turn. Sorry, on this turn. But then I'm only going to get away with 5 damage on the turn after, so that's only going to be 13. So I don't think I'm quite going to get there, am I? Oh, and I'm also going to run out of time, but that's okay, I'm just going to draw him. He got in hand, that's the question. Another 6 damage. Okay. Well, I can heal for 3. That's the best I can do right now. Just start going for him here. I do have enough damage in hand, it's just all lightning, so I can only do it one card at a time. I think I'm just going to draw and see if I can get some more healing now. Should have some more vitalizing frogs. Oh no, I've used all of them. That's not good news. Okay, let's Storm in. I'll just use a Crackling Beast to pay for it. If that doesn't get removed, then that'll get us closer to finishing him off. That's that Thunder Slug we were looking for before. Did not want that. No big damage cards particularly, but I suppose if we play this, then we'll get 2 new cards as well. Stormcalling is no help to us right now, so we'll pay for it with Stormcalling. Continue cards. Okay, that's not going to help us on the next turn, but well, I haven't got any, so that's not going to be a major problem. So, we'll definitely play a Spark Wisp, because if it doesn't heal, we'll get him on the next turn, and then we'll Delivery Crab. Card. Yep, so I'm not going to be playing that, obviously. Don't want him to be healing. And there we go. That is a good game, and we can finish him off there. Okay, so that should have finished off our mission for us. Yeah, okay. So we've got ourselves some more gold and some more gems, which we can put towards something eventually. At the moment, I'm just kind of storing up my gold. There's some, I don't know if you've noticed, but all the way to the right here, there are two playmats that are available for gold, 7,500 and 10,000 gold, so quite a lot of it. So I'm just saving up for one of those. I haven't quite decided which I'm going to go for yet. So yeah, we'll keep going at that. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed this video, and tune in again next time. Bye!